Hey yo, what's the lullaby with the Chico Jarhead dudes? And if you're new, looking for something to do, subscribe and officially join our rowdy crew. My name's Tyler, the host of the crypto channel that serenades better than this harp lady and cow. She moved them with her sweet songs. Now it's my turn, cause it's time for Chico Crypto. Well, I'll tell you this right now, no other YouTuber is going to do a video like this, as many don't understand how to do it, and a majority of the others deep down do not care about the crypto markets. So what type of video is this? Well, I'm going to get you guys prepared and ready to stake Ethereum, because the launch of Ethereum 2.0 and the Beacon Chain is right around the corner, slated for December 1st, and in the Chico Barracks, we spot the opportunities early and we don't delay, we seize them. And I actually made a similar video to this, which was kind of preparation for this video. I showed how to get set up for the Ethereum 2.0 testnet and begin staking with the Prysm client from Prysmatic Labs on the testnet for non-technical users. So first, what's the opportunity here? I thought Ethereum staking wasn't going to be providing much reward in the beginning. I mean, you go to calculators like stakingrewards.com and they estimate only 5.26% APY, which with 32 ETH, the amount needed to run a validator node, that is just over 1.6 ETH per year. Not much. And many are saying, well, that risk is not worth the reward. Well, I'm going to show you that maybe the risk might be worth that reward. So, for the Beacon Chain to go live, there is a minimum amount of validator nodes needed online. That number is 16,384, which is over 500,000 Ether if you add 32 ETH to each node. Now, they have a tracker of how many Ethereum are locked and how far progress is towards the validator node goal. As we can see, there is less than 50,000 Ethereum locked, and there are over 15,000 validators still needed, or 92% left to go. And the clock is ticking, 20 days left until December 1st. If you look at the growth of the deposit contract, initially a major boost when it launched, but it has been flattening out. And this is a good thing for the stakers who take the risk, because if you did not know, if Ethereum reaches only the minimum needed to launch, a staking APY could be 37% per year. 1 million ETH gets into the deposit contract, double the minimum, about 18%, and then 2.5 million, you're still over 10% APY. There is obviously a slow uptake of Ethereum 2.0 validators, so the early bird gets a frickin' worm. Those early stakers are going to be earning higher than projected APYs right out the gate. So why don't we become some of those early worms? Why don't we become the solo stakers where all the risk is put in the protocol and yourself, that's it, instead of a third party? User SuperFizz once again put out a warning, a video this time, which shows its seriousness, saying early third-party staking services are highly, highly risque. So let's do it. Solo stake. And sorry to burst your ready-to-pull-the-trigger bubble, but I'm not just going to do this in one video. This is preparation, guys. We are going to once again learn how to stake on the testnet today, because you better have your testnet node up and running smoothly, before even thinking about becoming a solo staker. So I've included the link to joining the Prysm testnet, which is the one I've been liking, and with this tutorial, we are going to get a tad more technical as we need it for mainnet go live, which with the last tutorial, we did the non-technical one, which was still pretty damn technical. So from their tutorial, our first step is to fetch and install Prysm for your operating system, which we will be doing the recommended using the Prysm installation script. So in here, I wouldn't go with minimum, I would go with the recommended specification, but it can be done with minimum, just make sure those are all checked before installing Prysm. We will be doing this on Windows, as that is what I use, but there are instructions for Linux, Macs, and even ARM64. So number one, before we get into their tutorial, we need to make sure to have Git installed on your computer. I've included the download link for Git. It's in the description. Once Git is downloaded and installed, going back to their tutorial, we need to install the Prysm startup script. And to do this, we need to open the command prompt. They have everything you need to copy and paste for this tutorial. So I would just copy and paste. As seen here, you create the directory. Copy and paste the next thing, and it will install Prysm from GitHub. And then finally, copy and paste the last to ensure logging appears properly. You may need to enter yes, and then it should say the operation is completed successfully. Now we're officially on to step two, getting our testnet ETH. They are running on the Goerli testnet, so you need 32 Goerli ETH. And the easiest way is to join their Discord server. Link for that is also in the description. And then joining the request Goerli ETH group. So you just need an Ethereum address, and I recommend creating one through MetaMask or whatever service you like. And then in that group, you just need to post exclamation point, send, and your address. And then the bot will automatically send the Goerli ETH to you. I did it, it's super easy. Now going back to MetaMask, whoa, where is my 32 ETH? Well, you have to change to the Goerli testnet to see them. Check, step two is done. Now we get into the fun stuff. Step three, running our beacon node. So first, before running it, you need to access the ETH1 node. And they have a dedicated instructions for doing just that. Now the most decentralized way to do it is to run your own ETH1 node, but that is a whole freaking video in itself. We will be using a third party provider, Infura. Sign up is free and easy, and it's included in the description. Once signed up for Infura, you just need to make sure on the left bar you're on Ethereum. Click New Project. Name it. We are calling ours Testnet Medalla. Save, and your project is created. But the next step is to change to the Goerli Testnet. Make sure to do that. Now it's time to use the Prysm installation script. Copy what they have from the tutorial, and this time do it in something like Notepad or WordPad. And then you just need to go back to Infura and copy your HTTPS endpoint, the top one, not the bottom. Make sure you are on Goerli. And now in Notepad, replace the piece, your ETH1 node endpoint, with your endpoint URL. Then copy that and paste it back into command prompt. And then just to make sure everything works, add space, dash dash, clear, dash db, to the end of it. This will clear any corrupted data if it's there, which could stop you. And then press enter. Everything should succeed, and you will know when you get an estimation of how long it's going to take to sync. Will take anywhere from 12 to 18 hours. Hey, step three is complete. Now step four, the onboarding process in the official ETH2 launch pad. Link for that is also in the description. So first, go through the sign up intro. It doesn't matter what client, we are going to use a third party. Click continue. Select Prysm. Continue. Now it's time to generate the key pairs. Select just one validator, then select your operating system. We are Windows. And now you need to download the CLI from GitHub. Download the correct one. We are getting the zip for Windows. Once the file is downloaded, you will need to extract it. And we will put it into our Prysm folder. Once extracted, click into the deposit folder. In it, it will have a file. Drag and drop that into a fresh command prompt window. Don't press enter. We need to go back to the launch pad and copy all of this and paste it with a space after deposit.exe in command prompt, as seen here. Now press enter. It will then ask you for the language you want your mnemonic phrase in. For English, just press enter again. Then it's going to ask for a password for this. And when you type it, nothing shows up, so don't freak out. Just make sure it's correct when you type. Press enter, and then you gotta retype it and press enter, and again, nothing will show up. Now your mnemonic phrase is shown. Write it down or copy it if you're okay with copying it. But write it down for sure once you get to mainnet. Once you have it copied, press enter when you have, and then you can just copy and paste it on the next screen. But again, do not save it open on your computer with the mainnet. That is a bad move. Press enter, and it will be creating them for you and show you where you can find them. Going there, they are where they should be. Very nice. Now that we're done with that, it's time to go back to the Launchpad. Check you're done and then click continue. Now you need to upload your deposit file. You can find that where the command prompt told you. Upload it, and it should show a check if you're good. Click continue. Now it's time to connect your wallet. Click the service and your correct wallet. Make sure you're on the Goerli testnet or those ETH won't show up. Click continue and it's connected. Click continue again. Go through the cautions, checking each box, and click continue. Now it's time to initiate the deposit transaction. Click to initiate. It will pull up MetaMask, confirm the transaction, and wait for the deposit. You can check Etherscan, but it should be done in under 30 seconds. And we are good. Transaction successful. Click continue, and we are complete with step 4. But we're not done. It's time for official step 5, importing validator accounts into Prysm. So make sure the beacon node is synced after about 12 to 18 hours. We are good to go. It's synced. Now open up a new command prompt window, and the first thing you will type is cd space prysm. Now go back to the tutorial, and in step 5, copy what's under the prysm bat script. Copy and paste this into Notepad. Now delete everything after the equal sign, and find the exact path to the wallet you created. The exact path. Copy and paste it into Notepad after the equal sign. Now, copy and paste all of that out of Notepad and into the command prompt window. Press enter. You will then be prompted to enter your password you created prior for the wallet. Enter it. Enter the same password again, and it should import the account. One for the one node wallet we created. Success. Finally, we get to official step 6, running your validator. You need to open a new command prompt window. Then again, type cd space prysm. Now from step 6, copy and paste what's under using the prysm bat script. Press enter. You will then need to re-enter the wallet password you created. Press enter. And if you see waiting for deposit, you are successful. But a note that it may take from 5 to 12 hours for nodes in the ETH2 network to process a deposit. In the meantime, leave both terminal windows open and running, your beacon and your validator waiting. But if you need confirmation of when it will be done and when your node will start processing blocks, you can just use beaconscan.com. And then enter the public key of your validator or wallet address. Click on the deposit and it will give you an estimated time. We are actually about 3 to 7 more hours to go. But once active, it will look exactly like this. Confirmation! We have our validator node running and securing with proof of stake on the Medalla testnet. So I pray you didn't get caught up, hung up with this tutorial, and I hope you didn't leave and abandon it. Remember, the early bird gets the worm, but even early birds still gotta put in the effort to pray. And you will too. We're preparing for mainnet. Cheers. I'll see you next time.